So if you happen to pick the x right here in this little tiny bit, when you move to the right, uh-oh, you went out of the region. If you go up, this y value is going to be more than 0.1 away from the 4. So now I'm going to use an actual number for epsilon and some pictures to explain this for you guys. So when we have this limit, if you run through the epsilon delta definition, the first step says for all epsilon greater than 0, that means you can pick any positive real number for epsilon. So let's say right here, I'm going to just set epsilon to be 0.1. And of course, you can also pick 0.2 or 0.007, up to you. Then it says there is going to be a delta. Well, earlier we have seen that we have two expressions for delta, but I'm going to work them out later. Right here, such that if this happens, then this will happen. Well, what do they mean? Firstly, when you see the absolute value, just think about it as distance. When you have x minus 2, that means we are talking about the distance between x and 2. When x is approaching 2, you're talking about the distance between x and 2. That distance has to be in between of 0 and delta. The reason that we have the 0 is because we don't need x to be exactly 2, and in fact, we don't want x to be exactly 2. And then, this right here says what? X squared, which is our function, and the 4, which is our limit, their distance is less than the epsilon that we selected earlier, which is 0.1. Now, we are going to begin by looking at this, and here is a picture that will help us visualize. And of course, we are talking about the function x squared, and here is the graph for it. And of course, we're talking about when x is approaching 2, so 2. Now, if you go up, the y value is, of course, 4. Okay. Now, what does this mean, though? X squared minus 4 is less than 0.1. Well, this is the error that you're allowed to make. Well, that's why we have the e, well, the epsilon, on the y. So, that means you can go up 0.1, and you can also go down 0.1. So if you go up 0.1, you will have 4.1. If you go down, you get 3.9. And now keep in mind, they are the same distance. Both of them are epsilon. One's going up, the other one's going down. That's all. Then we're going to look back here. This says, as long as the x is within the delta distance away from 2, then this will happen. So, we're talking about the x values. This is how we are going to do it. Start with 4.1 and just kind of come back here, hit the curve, and then go down so you can see the x value right here. And now let me ask you, what's the x right here? Well, the y is 4.1, so for x from here, take the square root, so this will be square root of 4.1. Do the same thing here. That will be square root of 3.9. Now, let me ask you, are they the same distance? No, in fact not, right? They look really close, but no. And the fast way for me to show you that they are not the same thing is to just show you the decimal computation. If you take square root of 4.1 minus 2, you get approximately 0.0248. If you do this minus that, you get approximately 0.0252. In fact, this right here is a little bit shorter than that. And you can also argue that because this goes up faster compared to that, that's why this is smaller length. But anyways, what you are going to do is, you are going to select the shorter one to be the delta. And this is like the maximum possible delta that you can set for this to work. Why? Let me show you. Here, this is the delta. Remember, this says, as long as x satisfies this condition, and in fact, this is symmetry, right? It's symmetrical. When you have this right here, you also can go to the left. Just like earlier, when you have the epsilon being 0.1 with the absolute value, you can go up and down 0.1. When you have the delta here, you can go to the right and go to the left, delta distance away. Right here, you see how I drew just a little bit and little bit. There is actually a small tiny bit of the blue part because this is slightly bigger than that. As long as x is in the red part right here, then you can be sure that when you go up, the function is going to be within 0.1 away from the limit, guaranteed. And if you do the same thing here, of course, same thing. But you might be wondering, why though? Why the smaller one? Remember, this thing, delta is going to help you left and right, right? You have to do left and right. So if you happen to pick the x right here in this little tiny bit, when you move to the right, you went out of the region. If you go up, this y value is going to be more than 0.1 away from the 4, and that's not what we want. So this is the delta from the picture. Now let's go back to the formula. First formula, like the fast way, we have epsilon over 5, epsilon is 0.1, so you will just get 0.02, okay. And now if you put 0.1 here, guess what? You get 4 plus 0.1 is square root of 4.1 and then minus 2. And this is what I mean by this is the best possible delta that you can come up with. It's precise. Why does this also work? Well, as long as your delta value is smaller than this one right here, it will work. Because remember, this is the maximum possible distance that you can go out from 2. Right here, you are only saying, hey, don't go too far away, just up to here maybe. If you are staying here, again, symmetrical, you can come here. This part, when you go up, you will be for sure within 0.1 away from 4, guaranteed. Any delta value smaller than 0.0248 will work. And of course, this is smaller than that, so this will also work. You can come up with infinitely many formulas for delta that will make this work. You can have epsilon over 27, that will work as well, but nobody does that. These are the two standard way. So hopefully this right here helps, epsilon delta definition. Check out my other videos if you need more practice for that. That's it.